Senator Rizzo Ontiveros says the Senate minority bloc will have at least 3 members. She adds, though, more than the numbers, what's more important is having a true minority inside Congress after President-elect Marcos and his allies dominated the recent elections.
Senado ang institusyon na sa nakaraang higit isang siglo ang tumayong independent sa maraming critical moments na kailangan meron talagang mag-raise di lamang ng independent na individual voice or voices, pero independent na institutional voice. Yan ang Senado. Yan ang tradisyon ng Senado. At nagawa rin niya ito dahil nagkaroon siya ng mga totoong minorya sa loob. Kaya essential talaga.
5 appointees of President Rodrigo Duterte bypassed by the Commission on Appointments. Commission on Elections Chief Saidamen Pangarungan, COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia, and Civil Service Commission Chief Carlo Nograles are among those who failed to keep their posts. Commission on Appointments Chairperson Senator Cynthia Villar says the adjournment of the hearing for their nominations was due to a lack of quorum. She adds the bypassed officials can still be reappointed by the Marcos administration, which now has the power to make its own picks. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles wants bloggers accredited for palace briefings. She says it will be among her top priorities once she officially leads the Presidential Communications Operations Office. She adds she could not say for sure if all journalists will be allowed to physically cover presidential events.
I think we'll have to take a look at the existing policy first and determine, make a decision later on as to how appropriate they are for the current times. Other than that, we'll have to wait and see pending, you know, a review of all existing policies regarding the coverage in Malacañang. We are, however, pushing for the accreditation of bloggers to be invited to some of the briefings, especially those conducted by the president event. So yun pa lang po, yun ang isa sa aming na-formulate na priority for the incoming PCOO.
Cruz Angeles, meanwhile, asserts the incoming Marcos administration is concerned about the safety of journalists. She says they are pushing for a new policy regarding the matter. A communications professor suggests COMELEC should regulate the hiring of bloggers by political parties to advance their interests. UP professor Rachel Khan says COMELEC should also look into the role of public relations firms in troll activities during the campaign period.
Many had benefited, and so I really doubt that they will come up with a legislation that will actually tackle the problem. What I am afraid of is that they will come up with legislation that is superficial and that will only penalize legitimate public discourse and actually limit our freedom of expression.
The poll body has said it will push for laws regulating social media and stopping the use of trolls during the campaign period. But Professor Khan believes this would be counterproductive, especially in a society wherein people engaging in honest public discourse are being red-tagged. She instead has this in mind.
It is a worldwide phenomenon. Where we have to start, perhaps, is the education system to help. You know, one of the nice things that we can do, or one thing that can be implemented, is to teach children from the elementary age the idea of fact-checking. When they are critical in their assessment of sources on the internet, of information on the internet, if we teach them how to think critically, then we have a better chance of, you know, fake news and all this trolling actually affect legitimate public discourse.
As the son of the late dictator prepares to assume the highest post in the country, the Marcos family assures Filipinos they will not revise history. Senator Aimee Marcos says they will only tell their side of the story and answer issues hounding their family. President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr., though, has been elusive in answering questions involving his father's regime.
I don't think that's our effort at all. We will not revise anything. All we will do is to also make known, make public, what we know, our side of the story, which we have perhaps been remiss in not telling, simply because we were so scared of traditional media, of all the abuse, the diatribe, the insult. So hindi na, naging tameme na. We'll just tell our side of the story as best we can.
As for outgoing Education Secretary Leonor Briones, she says the next administration should not forget the lessons of her history. She also calls on her successor, Vice President-elect Sara Duterte, to make sure Philippine history will continue to be taught properly in schools. Briones is a victim of martial law.
Huwag nating kalimutan. Kailangang itanim din natin sa isip natin yung ating kasaysayan, yung hirap na dinanas din natin bilang isang bansa, yung ating mga bayani, kasi that makes us distinct from perhaps robots or machines. We are looking forward na ipagpatuloy ang mandato ng konstitusyon natin sa Pilipinas na nagsasabi na each Filipino child has a right to quality education.
Incoming Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan to call for a review of the Duterte administration's Build, Build, Build program. That's to ensure no resources are wasted as he faces a tight budget due to elevated debt levels. While Balisacan acknowledges the importance of building infrastructure, he also wants to spend more on poverty alleviation and education. But he clarifies he will not stop ongoing projects of the government.
You need to balance the infrastructure side on the one hand and social protection, health, education. You know, what do you do with world-class infrastructure when your people are getting a rank, your children are ranked poor, the poorest in the region, you know? And that's the dilemma. You want to push for a world-class infrastructure, but look, the health is in crisis, the education is in crisis. So we need to go back and reflect, okay, what is really fundamental? What is development? To me, development is prosperity shared by all, especially the poor. And so I would like to see that the growth that we put in place are highly inclusive. We are not going to stop anything that is ongoing, and it's clear that we have to continue what's there. But obviously, if it's obviously wrong infrastructure, obviously you have to do something about that, right? But as soon as we get in, I'll be meeting my colleagues at NED before the inauguration of the president, so I should be able to see where we are.